Good day. Welcome. This is your Daily Med with Lady V. We have been talking about faith, and we certainly did talk about saving faith. And today we will talk about degrees of faith, that there is little faith, and that is our topic today, the measure of faith. But today we will look at little faith. In St. Matthew chapter 8, verse 23 through verse 26, it says, "Then he got into a boat, and his disciples followed him. Suddenly, a furious storm caught up on the lake, so that the waves swept over the boat. But Jesus was sleeping. The disciples went and woke him, saying, 'Lord, save us, we are going to drown.' He replied, 'You of little faith, why are you so afraid?' Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the waves, and it was completely calm. The men were amazed and asked, 'What kind of man is this? Even the winds and the waves obey him.'" As Jesus said unto them, he arose. He says, "You are fearful, but you are of little faith." Then he arose and rebuked the winds and the waves, and there was a calm. On this occasion, Jesus was crossing from the west side to the east side when a storm arose. He was asleep in the boat. The terrified disciples came to him. They woke him up with frantic pleas for help. It is to their credit, thank God, they went to the right person. So Jesus, after rebuking them for their puny or their tiny faith, he now rebuked the winds and the waves. And then there was a great calm. The men marveled that even the elements obeyed their humble passenger. They little comprehended that the creator and sustainer of the universe was in the ship that day. All believers encounter storms sooner or later in life. At times it seems as if we are swamped by the waves. There is comfort in knowing that Jesus is in our boat with us. No water can swallow up our boat, because the master of the ocean, the earth, and the skies are with us. No one can quell life's storms like the Lord Jesus himself. Therefore, we should have faith in God. St. Matthew 14, verse 22 through 23 is another one of our story where Jesus used this statement when Peter walked on the water, and then he became afraid and doubted. See, previously the disciples were with Jesus on the mountainside. They saw him miraculously multiplying 5 loaves and 2 fishes, and they saw the abundance of his provision, how he fed 5,000 men, not including women and children. Now they learn that this one can also what? Protect and empower them as well. Jesus dismissed the multitude. Then he told the disciples to get into the boat and to start back to the other side of the lake. He himself went on the mountain to pray, always communicating with the Father, always replenishing himself by prayer and in communion and fellowship with the Holy Spirit and his Father. So he went on the hillside to pray in St. Matthew 14, verse 24 through 27. The boat was now far from land, and then guess what happened? It began to battle a contrary wind. As the waves battered the boat, Jesus knew. He knew their plight. He knew they were in trouble on the waters. So in the fourth watch of the night, which is 3 a.m. to 6 a.m., he went to them walking on the sea. The disciples panicked because they thought they had seen a ghost. Then they heard the reassuring voice of their master and friend. Can you imagine? "Be of good cheer," he says. "It is I. Do not be afraid." Then Peter heard the well-known, well-loved voice. His affection and his enthusiasm begin to bubble all over him. He said, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." See, Peter knew whatever command God gives, as long as he obeys it, he would be all right. As soon as Jesus said, "Come," Peter jumped out of the boat and began walking towards him. As long as he kept his eyes on Jesus, he was able to do the impossible. But the moment he became occupied with the storm and what was going on around him, then he began to sink. Frantically, he cried, "Lord, save me." The Lord took him by the hand, gently rebuked his little faith, and brought him to the boat. As soon as Jesus went on board, the wind ceased. And I am sure there was a worship service that took place on the boat. The disciples had Jesus to their rescue. Peter in particular had Jesus to his rescue also. "Truly," they were saying, "yes, you are the Son of God." This even gave them further assurance that he is the master of the sea. And so he rescued them. In this Christian life, the believer sometimes is like walking on water. It is humanly impossible sometimes for the things that takes place in the believer's life. And so because of that, this Christian life can only be lived by the power of the Holy Spirit. As long as we look away from every other objects, every other things, everything else that distracts us, and look to Jesus, according to Hebrews 12 and verse 2, the one who is the author and the finisher of our faith, we can experience a supernatural life. But the minute we become occupied with ourselves or our circumstances, we will begin to sink. When this happens, we must cry to the Lord Jesus for help, for healing, for restoration, and divine enablement. Let us remember, faith comes by hearing God speak. So let us speak what He speaks, and let us faith walk and faith talk daily. Because when we speak the word of God, when we hear the word of God, when we allow those words to settle in our hearts, and when we even pray them back to God, then we are building our faith. So as you see today in the two circumstances in the Bible, Jesus addressed the disciples and He says to them, your faith is little. He says to Peter, your faith is little. So tonight, today, let us understand that we can have measures or varying degrees of faith. And let us continue to put our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and to grow from faith to faith. God bless you. Thank you again for watching. Please like, please subscribe, and please share.